Hello friends, today we will discuss about few important points from anesthesia for upcoming exams. First point is spinal cord ends at lower border of L1 and upper border of L2. The question will be at what level the spinal cord ends in adults. It ends at lower border of L1 or upper border of L2. Spinal cord ends at lower border of L1 or upper border of L2 in adults, whereas in children, the spinal cord ends at lower border of L2. Next point is structures puncture during spinal anesthesia. What are the structures puncture during spinal anesthesia? We have skin, subcutaneous tissue, supraspinous ligament, interspinous ligament, and ligamentum flavum. Dura, that is dura mater, and arachnoid. These are the structures punctured during spinal anesthesia. Skin, subcutaneous tissue, supraspinous ligament, interspinous ligament, ligamentum flavum, dura mater, and arachnoid mater. Next point is, what is the effect of spinal anesthesia on cardiovascular system? On cardiovascular system, it causes hypotension and it causes tachycardia. Spinal anesthesia causes sympathetic block, so it causes vasodilatation of lower limb blood vessels, which decreases the venous return, so it causes hypotension and tachycardia. Next one is, what is the cause for post-spinal headache? Post-spinal headache, what is the cause? It occurs due to leakage of CSF from the dural puncture site. This post-spinal headache is due to leakage of CSF from the dural puncture site. Usually, it occurs 12 to 24 hours after the anesthesia. It can last for about 7 days. How to treat this spinal headache? We can give analgesics and we should correct the dehydration. Next point is, what is the anesthesia of choice in pregnancy with cardiac diseases? What is the anesthesia of choice in pregnancy with cardiac diseases? The anesthesia of choice is epidural anesthesia. Epidural anesthesia is given in pregnancy with cardiac diseases. Next point is, what are the clinical features of malignant hyperthermia? This is one of the important topic. Malignant hyperthermia. What are the clinical features of malignant hyperthermia? It is a syndrome of rapidly rising temperature due to abnormality of rhinodin receptors. What are the clinical features? We can see masseter muscle spasm, tachycardia, rise in end-tidal carbon dioxide. We can see metabolic acidosis or respiratory acidosis. We can see hyperkalemia, hypernatremia, and cyanosis. As name suggests, hyperthermia, there is increase in temperature, but it is late sign of malignant hyperthermia. What is the most initial sign of malignant hyperthermia? It is masseter muscle spasm. Next point is, what is the most sensitive indicator of myocardial ischemia in perioperative setting? In perioperative setting, which is the most sensitive indicator of myocardial ischemia? This is transesophageal echo. Transesophageal echo. Next point is, what are the contraindications for bag and mask ventilation? Bag and mask ventilation contraindications are facial trauma, rapid sequence induction and intubation, and diaphragmatic hernia. In these cases, we don't use bag and mask ventilation. Next point is, what are the signs of endobronchial intubation? Endobronchial intubation. What are the signs? There is elevated peak inspiratory pressure. This is the first sign. There is elevated peak inspiratory pressure. In inspiratory pressure. And there is asymmetric chest expansion. Asymmetric chest expansion. And there is unilateral breath sounds. Unilateral breath sounds are heard. Next point is, what is the time required for pre-oxygenation before tracheal intubation? Time required for pre-oxygenation before tracheal intubation, it is 3 minutes. Next point is, what are the advantages of irradiation of granulocytes before blood transfusion? What are the advantages? It reduces the graft versus host reaction and it also reduces the febrile reactions. And it decreases the chance of reperfusion injury. It decreases the reperfusion injury, febrile reactions and graft versus host disease. Next point is, most commonly injured peripheral nerve following anesthesia. It is ulnar nerve. Ulnar nerve. Next point is, what is the inhalational agent of choice for maintenance in patient with liver disease? Inhalational agent of choice for maintenance in patient with liver disease. In patient with liver disease, it is sevoflurane. Sevoflurane. Next point is, what is the drug of choice for rescue analgesia? What is the drug of choice for rescue analgesia? It is fentanyl. Fentanyl. Drug of choice for rescue analgesia. What is the most potent inhalational anesthesia? Most potent inhalational anesthesia is halothane. Most potent inhalational anesthesia is halothane. Whereas most epileptogenic inhalational agent is enflurane. Epileptogenic inhalational anesthesia is enflurane. How to remember this? Epileptic E, enflurane E. You can remember like this. Next one, airway reflex is best preserved with which of the intravenous anesthesia? Airway reflex. Airway reflex is best preserved with which of the IV anesthesia? It is ketamine. Next one is, what is the most common complication of celiac plexus block? Most common complication of celiac plexus block. It is postural hypotension. Postural hypotension. Next one is, most common cardiac rhythm seen in adults experiencing sudden cardiac arrest. Most common cardiac rhythm seen in adults experiencing sudden cardiac arrest. It is asystole. This is the most common cardiac rhythm seen in adults experiencing sudden cardiac arrest. Next point is, what is the surest sign for tracheal intubation? What is the surest sign of tracheal intubation? It is capnography. Next one is, at which site we can accurately measure the brain temperature? What is that site we can accurately measure the brain temperature? The site is tympanic membrane. We can accurately measure the brain temperature in tympanic membrane. And distal esophagus is the best site for core temperature. Next point is, what is meant by high quality CPR? High quality CPR. It means there will be chest compression at 100 to 120 per minute. the chest compression should be done at 100 to 120 per minute, and rotation of chest compressor is done every 2 minutes or earlier. Next one is, what is the technique of choice for elective caesarean section in coarctation of aorta? In caesarean section with coarctation of aorta, the technique of choice is general anesthesia. Next one is, ideal choice for epidural analgesia during labor. Epidural analgesia during labor, the ideal choice is bupivacaine plus fentanyl. This is the ideal choice for epidural analgesia during labor. Next one is, maximum oxygen delivered by venturi mask is 60%. Maximum oxygen delivered through venturi mask is 60%, whereas through nasal cannula it is 40%. Next point is, what is the drug of choice for bradycardia in children? Drug of choice for bradycardia in children, it is intravenous epinephrine, IV epinephrine. Next one is, what is the shortest acting opioid? What is the shortest acting opioid? It is remifentanil. Remifentanil is the shortest acting opioid. It acts for about 8 to 20 minutes. Next one is, what is balanced resuscitation? What is balanced resuscitation? It means restrictive use of fluids and blood products. It has two components. One is hypotensive resuscitation. In this, BP is not targeted to reach to normal level. Second component is hemostatic resuscitation, that is with blood components with the aim of maintaining circulating volume. The blood components like RBC, FFP and platelet, it should be given in a ratio of 1:1:1. That means RBC, fresh frozen plasma and platelet. These has to be given in the ratio of 1:1:1. Next point is, what is the most common cause of maternal mortality followed by a general anesthesia? Most common cause of maternal mortality following a general anesthesia, it is pulmonary aspiration. Next one is, the patients of which ASA grading can be taken for organ donation? For organ donation, we can take the patients of ASA grading 6. These are the brain dead patients. They can be taken for organ donation. ASA grading 6. Next point is, what is the thyromental distance for adequate airway? What is the thyromental distance for adequate airway? It is more than 6.5 cm. Whereas sternomental distance should be more than 12.5. Sternomental distance should be more than 12.5 cm. So these are the few important points from anesthesia for upcoming exams. One of the important topic is whether to continue drug on the day of surgery or whether to stop that drug, when to stop the drug. That topic is also important. Regarding oral hypoglycemics or insulin, the morning dose should be omitted. That means we should skip the morning dose on the day of surgery. Insulin, we should skip on the day of surgery. And low molecular weight heparin, it has to be stopped at least 12 to 14 hours before surgery. Low molecular weight heparin should be given at 12 to 14 hours before surgery. The last dose should be at least 12 to 14 hours before surgery. Whereas unfractionated heparin, the last dose can be given up till 6 hours before the surgery. OCPs has to be stopped 4 weeks before the surgery, whereas progesterone only pills can be continued. And antihypertensives, the morning dose has to be taken. Antihypertensive should be taken on the day of surgery. And we should continue the thyroid drugs also, because the patient has to be in euthyroid states at the time of surgery. These should be continued. And ideally, smoking should be stopped 6 to 8 weeks before the surgery. Low dose aspirin can be continued during surgery except for a closed space surgery like brain surgery, spinal cord surgery or surgery in eyes. Except these three, we can continue low dose aspirin on the day of surgery also. Whereas aspirin of a dose more than 75 mg, it has to be stopped before 3 to 5 days prior to surgery. And clopidogrel has to be stopped 7 days before surgery. Sildenafil has to be stopped 24 hours prior to surgery. We can continue statins and steroids. NSAIDs has to be stopped 2 days prior to surgeries. So in this session, I have discussed few important points from the anesthesia for upcoming PG entrance exam. If you like this video, please click like button and share this video to your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more rapid series. Thank you.